एवरीवन, वेलकम टू टेस्का टेक्नोलॉजी प्राइवेट लिमिटेड। माय नेम इज आशिम दत्ता एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट डीसी मोटर स्पीड कंट्रोल यूजिंग पीडब्ल्यूएम एंड एससीआर एंड इट्स ऑर्डर कोड इज 52032। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इट्स वर्किंग। नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द वर्किंग ऑफ दिस किट। सो फॉर दैट वी हैव टू परफॉर्म एन एक्सपेरिमेंट, दैट इज ओपन लूप स्पीड कंट्रोल फॉर पीडब्ल्यूएम कंट्रोलर विद एंड विदाउट लोड। सो first of all we will do the connections. The DSO probe should be connected with the kit like this, then this male to female cable is connected like this with this motor, then we will do the probe connections. We will connect the positive terminal with the VT, then we will connect the negative terminal with the ground one. Now we will switch on the kit and DSO. So for without load we have to keep this at 90 degree position like this. When we keep this position like this, then this is with load. So first of all we will perform the experiment with without load. So we have to keep this at 90 degree position like this. Now we will vary the KA using this knob. So here on the DSO you can observe that square wave appears. Now we will take readings at 25%, 50%, 75% and 100%. So you can observe on the DSO like this, that this is the 25%. Now we will do it for 50%. So we have to keep the square wave like this. So this is for 50%. Now we will do it for 75%. So here you can see that the voltmeter reading is 0.31 and the RPM reading is 2276. So that is how the RPM changes according to the voltage, and as we vary the KA this voltage and RPM reading changes. Now we will take it for 100%. So at 100% the reading is 0.32 and 24,400 is the RPM reading. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now we will perform the experiment with load. So we have to keep this motor at this position. So now this is at with load. Now we will switch on the kit. So the connections will be same. The positive terminal is connected to the VT, the negative terminal is connected to the ground. So the connections will remain same. Now we will vary the KA using this knob. So here on the DSO you can observe that the waveform appears and this is the square wave. So similarly we have to take the readings for with load also, for 25%, for 50% and 75%. So this is the 25%. And now we will take for 50%, then we will take it for 75%. So here on the voltmeter you can see that the voltage increases, and on the RPM meter you can observe that the RPM reading increases. So as you vary the KA, the voltmeter reading and the RPM reading varies, and you can observe the waveform on the DSO like this. So that is how you can take the reading for 75%, for 50%, for 25%, and for 100%, like this. And you can form a table of voltmeter and RPM reading. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now we will perform another experiment, that is closed loop speed control for PWM controller with and without load. So the connections will remain same, just we have to do a connection for closed loop, that is we have to connect the VT and VF. So now this becomes closed loop connection and the switch remain at PWM position. Now we will switch on the kit. So first of all we have to do the experiment for without load. So we have to keep this at 90 degree position like this. So now this is without load. Now we will vary the KA. So as we vary the KA, we can observe that on the DSO there is a square wave, and as we vary it for 25%, 50%, 75% and 100%. So we can observe that the voltmeter reading changes and the RPM meter reading also changes. And we can form a table like this for 25%, for 50%, for 75% and for 100%. So this is at 75%. You can see it on the DSO. Then for 50%, you have to keep this KA knob like this. So this is for 50%, then this is for 25%, and if you want it for 100%, you have to maximize the knob. So that is how you can adjust the knob and you can take the readings as per the table. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now we will perform the experiment for with load. So for that we have to keep this position like this. So now this is with load and the connections will remain same. Now we will vary the KA. So here on the DSO you will observe the square wave. So similarly we have to take the readings for 25%, for 50%, for 75%, and you can take it for 100% also. So as you vary the KA knob, you can see the variations in the square wave, and that is how you can take the readings for 75%, for 50%, for 25% and 100%, like this. So that is how you can perform this experiment. Now we will perform another experiment, that is open loop speed control for SCR controller with and without load. So first of all we will do the connections like this. Just we will remove this closed loop circuit, the VT to VF connection, we will remove it, and now the connections will be same as the earlier experiments. Now we will switch on the kit and we will keep this switch at SCI position. Now we will adjust the axis like this on the DSO. Now we will vary the KA, and for without load we have to keep this at 90 degree position like this. Now KA knob will be adjusted to get the square wave on the DSO. So here on the DSO you can observe the square wave like this. Now we will adjust the KA knob and that is how we can take the readings. And here also we have to take the readings as 25%, 50%, 75% and 100%. So we will adjust the KA to get the readings. So this is for 75%, then this is for 50%. You can see the variations on the voltmeter and RPM meter, and you can form the table of voltmeter reading and RPM reading like this. So observe the readings and the waveform, and that is how you can perform this experiment. So here you can see that this is for 25%, then this is for 50%, then this is for 75%, and for 100%, you can see it like this. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now we will do it for with load. So for that we have to keep this at this position. The motor position should be like this. Then we will vary the KA. So this is for with load. So here on the DSO you can observe that the square wave appears. And here also you have to take the readings as 25%, 50%, 75%, and you have to form this table. You can see the changes on the voltmeter and RPM meter. So that is how you can take it for 75%, then for 50%, then for 25%, then for 100%. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now we will perform another experiment, that is closed loop speed control for SCR controller with and without load. So the connections will be remain same. For closed loop we have to connect the VT and VF. So now this becomes closed loop connection and the switch should be at SCR. Now we will keep this motor position like this for without load. Now we will switch on the kit and now we will adjust the KA. So as we increase the KA, we can observe that the square wave appears on the DSO. So similarly you have to take the readings for 25%, 50%, 75% and 100% for without load like this. And you can take the voltmeter and RPM reading from this kit. So that is how you can vary the waveform and take the readings. Now for with load, we have to keep this motor position like this. And now we will adjust the KA. So as we increase the KA, we can observe the waveform on the DSO and the voltmeter and RPM reading on the kit. And you can form this observation table like this for 25%, for 50%, for 75%, and you can take it on 100% also. So that is how you will perform this experiment. Adjust the KA so that you can get the 75% reading, 50% reading, 25% reading and 100% reading like this. So that is how this experiment is performed. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any query related to this kit, you can contact at Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this, like, share and subscribe to our channel.